basketball fans, and welcome to Game 2 of our UDC basketball doubleheader this afternoon. Game 2 features your UDC men's basketball team taking on the men's basketball team from Queens College. This should be a very close competitive game this afternoon. Both teams come in 10-8 on the season, and just a half game separates these two teams in the conference standings. The Firebirds come in tied for second in the ECC standings with a 7-3 conference mark. Queens comes in tied for fourth, they're 7-4. So this game, a big implication on postseason possibilities for both these teams as we get into the second half of conference play. So now without further ado, let's take a look at this afternoon's starting lineups. And we'll first take a look at the starting lineup for the visiting Queens College Knights as they will go with 5'10 senior Marquise Roberts in the backcourt. He will be joined by 6'4 senior Diego Maldonado. In the front court for Queens, they'll go with 6'4 senior Malcolm Moore, 6'4 senior Tyree White, and 6'7 freshman Kevin Buron, getting just his seventh start of the season. Now the starting lineup for your UDC Firebirds, who are led by fourth-year head coach Mike Riley. He's assisted by Terrell Stokes and Anthony Iotti. In the backcourt, the Firebirds will go with four guards. They'll have 5'11 senior Kasim Chandler, joined by 6'2 junior Trayvon Butler, 6'4 senior Joseph Nickerson, who leads the team in scoring, and 6'4 senior Reggie Sidbury. And the one front court player for the Firebirds this afternoon will be 6'9 junior Kyle Williams. Firebirds dressed in their gold jerseys and shorts this afternoon with black numbers on the front and back. Firebirds written across the front of the jerseys, thick black stripe down the side of the jerseys and shorts. Queens dressed in blue jerseys and shorts, thick white stripe down the side of their jerseys and shorts, red numbers on the front and back with white trim. And I believe, once they turn around, I'll know for sure what it says on the front of their jerseys. It says Knights in red lettering with white trim. White lettering, red trim. So here we go, folks. Buckle up. This should be a good one. Firebirds looking to halt a two-game losing skid. They lost their last game at Damon 97-77. That was the third game in a row on the road for the Firebirds. So they'll be looking to get back to their winning ways. They won four in a row prior to this two-game losing skid. Queens, meanwhile, has won three in a row. They're coming off a win at Mercy on Wednesday night, 89-82. Firebirds' loss against Damon was last Saturday. Will be Kasim Chandler to inbound for UDC from the far sideline. Chandler inbounds to Nickerson. Now we can really get going. Butler hands off to Nickerson. He'll fire the deep two from the corner and connect. A good start for the Firebirds. They capitalize on their first possession of the game, and UDC is on top 2-0. Tyree White is the leading scorer for Queens on the season. Dished off to Buron and foul away from the basketball. Stops the clock with 19:27 to go here in this first half of play. So it'll be Malcolm Moore to inbound, gets it into Maldonado, who makes his way into the lane, splitting two defenders, and draws a foul on the layup attempt. Team foul number two on the Firebirds, and the second personal on Kyle Williams. So he's picked up two early ones, and he'll have to check out of the game. The big 6'9 junior from Freeport, New York. Tallest player the Firebirds have on their roster, but that may have been Queen's strategy. Get him into foul trouble early, and they did just that. Not even a minute into this one, Kyle Williams with two quick ones. So Khalil Jackson will check in for him. after that first made free throw. This Queens team shooting 70% from the free throw line on the season. We are tied at two, 19-22 to go in half number one. Butler drives into the lane, goes up left-handed, has his shot blocked. But now the Firebirds causing havoc on the defensive end. Ball is loose. Looks like it's recovered by Queens. Do we have a jump ball? We do. Jump ball and possession arrow will favor the Firebirds. Nickerson inbounds to Chandler. Chandler feeds Jackson. Looks down low, doesn't find anyone. Finds Zinberry to his left, who buries the deep two. Foot was on the line, so the Firebirds now up by two, 4-2. 18:46 remaining in this first half. You're on. Dishes off to White, who will be left alone to bring it up. Tyree White was named to the ECC Honor Roll on Monday. Led the team with 21 points and 14 rebounds in Queens' win on Wednesday night at Mercy. He was named the ECC Player of the Week on November 21st. Three-pointer drilled by Malcolm Moore. So it's a one-point Knights lead. These two teams met back on December 10th. The Knights won that game, 72-56, up in Flushing, New York. Nickerson drives, cannot finish, but draws the blocking foul. So Klopp stops with 18:04 left in the half. And it will be Joseph Nickerson headed to the free throw line. He leads this team with 19.1 points per game on average. That ranks fourth in the ECC. He ranks first in the conference in steals per game, averaging 3.18. In fact, not only does he rank first in the conference in that category, he ranks first in all of Division I in steals per game. So he hits the first free throw, and he ranks third in the nation in total steals. So he is having himself a season. Nickerson has been named the ECC Player of the Week twice this year, back on November 14th and on January 17th. And he gives UDC, again, a one-point lead, 6-5, with 18:04 left in the half. Firebirds pressing here early. Queens able to break. Now have 3-on-1. An easy layup from the right side for Diego Maldonado. So the Knights now back on top by one. And we have a jump ball, Knights with possession. Mentioned this during the women's game earlier, but according to Firebirds assistant coach Terrell Stokes, he thinks very highly of this Knights team. Thought they were one of the toughest teams they faced during the first half of conference play. The East Coast Conference, everyone plays each other twice during conference play. Beautiful feed down low to Maldonado. And he has it deflected way out of bounds. It will stay Knights basketball with 16 on the shot clock. 17:34 on the first half game clock. Moore inbounds. Gets it into Buron. Has the ball stripped away. It's loose. And now Firebirds coming away with a steal. 3-on-none. And Sidbury with the two-handed slam. So Firebirds back on top by 1-8-7. 17-18 to go. Firebirds had a week off to prepare for this one. Showing early on, they look like they have an extra pep in their step. Now foul called on UDC team's third of the half. First personal called against Joseph Nickerson. So Queens basketball from the front court baseline. Moore gets it in to White. Now Moore, the shot goes long. Rebound by Jackson for the Firebirds. Chandler, pop, stops, fires. but does not get it to fall in. Everything looked good about that attempt except for the finish. Turnaround J by Maldonado, and he hits a very difficult shot. So it's now the Knights back up by one as the teams trade jabs here in the early going. Chandler hands off to Nickerson. He feeds Butler. Now Chandler cross court to Jackson, who drives in, has his shot blocked by Buron. Loose ball recovered by White. White into the front court. Hands off to Maldonado, who fires a deep three, but no one in his face, and he makes the Firebirds pay. A lapse there on defense by UDC. We get a 30-second timeout call. This will, I believe, turn into the first media timeout. So I'll step away. Firebirds trail by four, 12-8, 16-13 left in the first half of play. This is UDC Firebirds men's basketball on University of the District of Columbia television.
An advanced public system of higher learning that serves the community of the District of Columbia. We selected all of those words very carefully because they all have important meanings. Because none of it really works unless you have a public higher education system that can connect it all together. Well, one of the best kept secrets about the University of the District of Columbia is that we have many quality programs. Our workforce development unit is of a high quality and puts people in jobs each and every day. Our land grant unit, which is serving constituents all over the district. We're the only urban land grant institution in the country. I think that we have all the pieces that we can put together in a way that will allow us to take best practices, best tools, and really wipe the slate clean and redesign ourselves as a advanced public system of higher learning that can serve the district in a way that allows us to be a model of higher education in a city that wants to be a model city for the rest of the country.
Being a champion takes more than skill, more than endless drills, more than using your head. Being a champion takes the heart to give it your all, the agility to thrive from any angle, and the relentless drive to be the best. Welcome to Division II, where the pursuit is yours to create, and the question isn't, can you do it? It's, will you?
Back underway, Firebirds with possession down by four, 16-10 to go. Here in the first half, UDC just spending their first time out of the game. They have three remaining. Chandler on top of the arc. Bounce pass left to Sidbury. Looks like some contact underneath on against Butler, not called. Shot put up by Jackson, comes up short. Now under 16 remaining in the half. White. Backs down his defender, goes up with a shot, and hits from the right low block. So lead has stretched to six, 14-8 after these two teams traded one-point leads for a couple of minutes. Deep three from Nickerson comes out flat. Rebound to the Knights. Beautiful feed to the baseline for Moore, but a foul away from the basketball. Unless they're saying Moore stepped on the baseline, I believe that might be the call. Simon Green will check into the game for Queens. Referee's making sure he had his jersey tucked in. Our officials this afternoon are Paul Huovinen, Patrick Langford, and Adam Eisenberg. Chandler into the front court. Swings it to Sidbury. Now Chandler drives right of the lane and draws the foul. Score the bucket to make it a four-point game. Now, Kasim Chandler, who's a 76% free throw shooter on the season, headed to the free throw line for the first time this afternoon. Firebirds 2 of 2 from the line thus far. Chandler, Sidbury, and Nickerson, the only ones to score for UDC this afternoon. Meanwhile, Diego Maldonado already has 9 for Queens. And Chandler able to complete the 3-point play. So it's 14-11. Queens on top, 14:54 remaining in this first half of play. Moore. Bounce pass left to Grant. Now Maldonado feeds White. Nickerson playing good defense on him. Grant to White. He starts to drive. Now wide open Moore for 3 from the corner. Off the mark. Grant the offensive board, and he puts it in from the left side. Isaac Grant, the freshman from Jamaica, New York, putting Queens on top by 5. Chance of defense coming from the Queens bench. Chandler, hand checked. Foul's called on Maldonado. That's his first personal, team's 3rd. Subs in for both teams. Tyrone Hall and Kaihem Chaplin in for Queens. Shaquem Folks in for UDC, as well as Anthony Matthews. So it's Folks, Matthews, Chandler, Sidbury, and Nickerson on the court for the Firebirds. Nickerson, one touch pass to Matthews for 3. No good. Rebound pulled down by Green. Green works against Chandler. Hands off to Hall, but before that, offensive foul called. So that is the team's 4th. The second personal on Green. He'll have to check out of the game for Queens. Marquise Roberts back in for him. Queens right now under the guidance of first-year head coach Michael Murray. And Sidbury hits the triple. Sidbury makes it a 2-point game, 16-14. 13:25 left here in this first half. Or pardon me, not Michael Murray. First-year head coach Matt Collier. Again, it's Matt Collier who's the head coach. Michael Murray, one of his assistants. Apologies for that. As Chandler pump fakes a 3. Now Nickerson fires it up from downtown and comes up short. Matt Collier spent six seasons as an assistant at Division I Drexel before taking over the program here at Queens. Roberts can't hit. Rebound recovered by Folks, and then miscommunication on the pass, but Firebirds recover the loose ball. Nickerson ahead to Sidbury from the corner. This one is short. Roberts works it into the front court. 12:23 left in the half. White swings far side for Chaplin. Now miscommunication. Queens nearly loses it. And we have a whistle, as it looks like Tyrone Hall may have gotten clocked in the eye. He'll check out of the game. Subs in for both teams. Trayvon Butler, Khalil Jackson back in for UDC. Nickerson will take a seat for the Firebirds. As well as Chandler. Maldonado, the fadeaway, rims out. Rebound for Matthews for the Firebirds. He races in the front court. Jackson fires it cross court, but Butler was cutting the other way. The miscommunication there leads to the Firebirds' turnover. 3rd turnover of the game for UDC. Still 3 fewer than Queens has committed. Two of the six Queens turnovers resulted from steals. Foul committed by Trayvon Butler. Brings us to the under 12 media timeout. Firebirds trailing by 5, 19-14, with 11:50 to go here in the first half of play. You're watching UDC Firebirds men's basketball on University of the District of Columbia television.
The whole point of the University of the District of Columbia is to allow every individual who walks into our doors to achieve his or her highest level of potential.
It's a melting pot. I grew up in a very diverse country amongst different cultural people, and being at UDC felt like being home.
I think that combination of the international students, and then there's a lot of students here that are coming back to school and they're older age. So it's very well-rounded in that way.
So that to be able to combine the quality with the affordability and the diversity makes us something special and unique in higher education. The people that we serve, which are generally DC public school graduates, although we serve students from all over the world and all over the country, part of what has to happen is that they need to see a better place and a better time and a better possibility in their lives, which is why we say that UDC is the place where dreams begin.
From court to court and lane to lane, under the lights or under the sun, no one delivers Division II sports like NCAA.com. The center of D2 is inside the NCAA.com hub, with exclusive highlights of every sport and live broadcasts of every Division II championship. Found nowhere else. Make NCAA.com yours. The home of Division II college sports.
Queens basketball as we get back underway. 11:50 to go in the first half. Eli Pearlstein with you. Jackson nearly stripped the ball from White. He recovers, however. Dishes off to Roberts. Now Roberts into the lane. Puts up the one-hander, too strong. Rebound hauled down by Nickerson for the Firebirds. Nickerson, Matthews, Jackson, Butler, and Folks on the court for the Firebirds. Nickerson feeds Matthews. He works against White. One-touch pass from Jackson down low to Folks, but he can't hit the easy layup from the right side. Rushed it. So the Firebirds remain down by 5 with 11:10 to go in the half. White dribbles towards the far sideline. Grant comes to set a screen. White elects not to use it. Now he'll drive to the baseline, puts up the mid-range jumper and scores. Tyree White, second team All-ECC a year ago. He was also the conference's defensive player of the year. Ranks third in the ECC in rebounds per game this season, fourth in field goal percentage. He's also 15th nationally in double-doubles. By far the best player on this Queens roster. Isaac Grant will check out of the game for the Knights as Khalil Jackson heads to the free throw line. Firebirds a perfect 3 of 3 from the stripe this afternoon. And there goes the announcer's jinx. Sorry about that, Khalil. Deficit remains 5. Roberts. Bounce pass to Hall. Back to Roberts, who works against Chandler. Number 1 versus number 1. Hall drives. Layup won't go. Buron can't hit the putback. And a foul called on the Knights. Team 6th. The next foul by Queens means free throws the rest of the half for the Firebirds, with half of this first half remaining. Chandler works it into the front court. Passes back to Nickerson. He swings to Jackson, who tries to fire underneath to Butler. Pass too far in front of him. Goes out of bounds. 9:51 left. Maldonado. Double teamed. Falls on the ball. And Queens able to call a timeout, I do believe. So this is a called timeout by Queens. 30-second timeout called by Diego Maldonado. Very heads-up play to keep possession for the Knights. At the University of the District of Columbia, the entire city is our campus. From the new community college and workforce development programs to the extension services and more, the university is active in every ward of the city, educating and enriching the lives of students, neighbors, and stakeholders. For more information, visit the UDC website at www.udc.edu. It will be hauled at inbound for Queens. From the baseline, gets it into White, works against Nickerson. This is a fun matchup to watch. White shoots over Nickerson, can't get it to fall, and ball is loose. Covered by Chandler, who then has his legs taken out from underneath by Isaac Grant. So Grant commits the foul, team seventh, and free throws coming up for Kasim Chandler. Chandler 1-of-1 from the free throw line today. Firebirds as a team have shot free throws very well this season. 77% clip from the stripe. And Chandler converts. Make it 21-17. He'll make them both. The Firebirds are within a score. 9:31 remaining in the half. Been close throughout. Two 10-8 teams going at it. Firebirds 4-7 against Queens since joining the conference. The start of the 2011-2012 season. They are 3-2 against Queens when playing here in D.C. Firebirds trying to snap a two-game skid. Queens trying to win their fourth in a row. Queens has not won in D.C. since January 18th of 2014. Maldonado, the three, off the mark. Rebound to Chandler. He races into the front court. Fires back to Sidbury for three. No good. Rebound tracked down by White for the Knights. He'll race into the front court, works against Butler. Now Maldonado draws the foul. 8:40 remaining in the half. That is team foul number 6 on the Firebirds, so it will stay on the floor. Reggie Sidbury will check out of the game for UDC. Rakeem Folks in for him. Malcolm Moore back in the game for Queens, as well as Kaiheim Chaplin as Tyrone Hall and Diego Maldonado take a seat. Ball is stripped on the inbounds pass and then foul committed by Grant. See, pushed the other number 10, Jakeem Folks, to the ground. That is team foul number 7, or pardon me, team foul number 8 on Queens. Tyrone Hall will check back in as Isaac Grant has to take a seat. That's his second personal. So it's Jakeem Folks at the line, the junior from New York, New York. Transferred to UDC from Hostos Community College. He went to Hostos as well as Khalil Jackson. and Cameron Outlaw, all now on this Firebird squad. It's a two-point game, 21-19. Frederick Bowers into the game for the first time. Had the nice pump fake and drive. We'll stay Queens basketball, 8:19 remaining in the half. Knights get it into the hands of Hall. Hall feeds Bowers. Goes up right-handed. Tries to go up over Kyle Williams and comes up empty. Williams, remember, playing with two personals. They picked up early in this one. Now offensive foul is called on Nickerson. That's the Firebirds' seventh team foul. And the third personal on Nickerson. He'll have to take a seat, likely for the remainder of the half. Costly foul there. Now the referee is discussing something. Maybe a question of, since it was a, I guess they called a technical foul as well on Joseph Nickerson, who was not happy with that personal foul called against him. So these are technical free throws now, being shot by Malcolm Moore, and he hits the first. In a game that is likely to be close down to the wire, could come into play. As Moore makes the Firebirds pay, converting both, and now it will be Queen's possession. With the technical, it's now eight fouls apiece for each team. So free throws the rest of the way for both teams. But since it was an offensive foul, that's why it's not more free throws right now for Queens. And one of the referees over to the scorer's table to make sure everything was recorded correctly in the book. Which appears it has been. Next dead ball, meanwhile, will bring us to the under eight media timeout. Moore hands off to Chaplin. He drives right in the lane. Has a shot blocked from behind by Jackson. Here come the Firebirds in transition. Jackson open, drives, gives up what would have been an easy look at a layup. A little surprised about that. Firebirds now set up their offense. Not sure about that decision by Jackson. He had a lane to the hole, put it up. Meanwhile, the big man puts it up. Kyle Williams converts with the left hand, and UDC within two. So 23-21, 7:23 remaining in the half. Roberts in the lane, goes up for the mid-range jumper and connects. Lead back to four, and chance of defense again from the Queens bench. Sidbury, screen set by Williams, hands off to Chandler. Chandler into the lane, passed up the jumper, smart. He felt the defender right on his back. It would have been blocked. Now Williams in the paint, goes up right-handed and converts. Williams doing work with the one-handed shot down low over Bowers, taking advantage. Firebirds obviously like that matchup of the bigs down low. According to their official heights, Williams with 3 inches over Bowers. Bowers, though, with the 15-pound advantage. So the team's trading punches. The lead shifts from 2-4 over the last couple of minutes. Still have not had the under eight media timeout. Matthews to Sidbury. Back to Matthews. feeds Williams again. This time he cannot hit the layup. Found himself a bit too far underneath the backboard. Not the best angle to go up with it. 3-pointer from Chaplin, no good. Williams the easy rebound. Matthews pulls up. Williams comes to set a screen. Matthews uses it twice, gets to the baseline, then kicks out to Khalil Jackson for a three, who drains it. And the Firebirds are back within one. 5:20 left in this one. Roberts hands off to Chaplin. Now the Firebirds come away with a steal, and it's Kasim Chandler who can't hit the layup from the right side, but great job by Matthews following the miss. Now Sidbury for a three, comes up empty. Jackson the offensive rebound, but he doesn't take the best angle to the net. Golden opportunities for the Firebirds to jump back out to the lead. They come up empty. And finally, we have a dead ball under eight. Brings us to the under eight media timeout. 4:51 remaining. Firebirds down by one. You're watching UDC Firebirds men's basketball on University of the District of Columbia television.
I have the best job of anyone I know. I am surrounded by intensely committed, hard-charging lawyers for social change. Lawyers who care about social justice, staff who are here at the law school because of our mission. Our law school has a completely different, pervasive educational methodology. We learn by doing. So instead of taking a course where you read books and articles about juveniles enmeshed in the criminal justice system, at the David A. Clark School of Law, you represent children charged with crimes or children who are in the abuse and neglect system or children with special education needs in court or in administrative hearings. You actually, as a student with close faculty supervision, change their lives. And that's how you learn.
So it's Marquise Roberts shooting 1-1 free throws for the Knights. Marquise Roberts, the senior from Brooklyn, New York, able to sink the first as the team now queens a perfect 5 of 5 from the free throw line. They're shooting 45.5% from the field in the half, 37.5% from three-point range. And he gets them both, so the Knights remain perfect at the stripe. The lead is 3-29-26. Firebirds in their last possession before that break had ample opportunities to get back in the lead. They've held the lead numerous times here in the first half, but could not convert on any of them. Jackson into the paint. Fires to Folks, who hits the two. And it's again a one-point game, 29-28. 4:25 left in the half. Moore works against Sidbury. Maldonado drives into the lane, feeds White down low, who draws a foul, a hard foul. I believe it will go against Jackson. No, pardon me, it goes against Jakeem Folks. Firebirds' 10th team foul as Tyree White goes to the line. The Firebirds have done a good job defensively on White. You can tell they're game plan was to hone in on him. White with 4 points in the half. This is his first trip to the line. He's able to sink the first. Diego Maldonado still leads the way for Queens with 9 points. Reggie Sidbury leads the way with 7 for the Firebirds. One more to try and make it again a three-point game. White unable to do that. Jackson soars up high to get the rebound for the Firebirds. Chandler fires from straight away. Three ball is off the mark. Under four now to go in the half. Pump fake from Hall. He drives, has a shot blocked by Jackson. Second block by Jackson this afternoon. Matthews back to Jackson. Thought about the three, gives it up. Now Matthews to Chandler, who spins in the lane, but before the shot, draws the foul on the floor. Still two free throws coming up for Chandler, however. We've reached the under four media timeout, 3:31 remaining. Firebirds and Queens playing a good one here on University of the District of Columbia Television.
As an integral part of the University of the District of Columbia, the Department of Intercollegiate Athletics provides experiences that enhance the comprehensive development of our student athletes. With a commitment to excellence, we embrace the overall mission of the NCAA with an emphasis on Division II to provide growth opportunities through academic achievement, learning in high-level athletic competition, and development of positive societal attitudes in service to community. In addition, we are committed to providing a game environment which respects fairness, courtesy, and ethical conduct towards others. We are the University of the District of Columbia, an advanced public system of higher learning where dreams begin.
Sim Chandler to the free throw line to shoot a pair, or pardon me, to shoot 1-1 for the Firebirds. So I guess that's why he was a little upset that he didn't get the call on the shot. He is able to make the first, so he will get a second. Chandler second in the ECC when it comes to steals per game. He's 16th in the nation in free throws made and 17th in free throw attempts. Makes one of two. So the lead is one. Firebirds have not led since early in this first half. A foul is committed. So it will be Marquise Roberts to the free throw line for Queens. That foul was on Chandler, his second personal. Firebirds have to be a little wary about some of their stars in foul trouble. We still got over 3 minutes remaining in the half. Joseph Nickerson likely not coming back into this game. He has, in this half that is, he has three personals. Chandler and Kyle Williams each with two personals. Trayvon Butler also with two personal fouls. Matthews swings to Chandler. He drives left of the lane. Now Sid Berry loses the basketball, but because he has it poked away from behind, a reach-in foul is the call. Exactly 3 minutes left in the half. Cameron Outlaw waits to check in for UDC. Same with Kaiheim Chaplin for Queens. Sid Berry, good on the first attempt. Sid Berry, an 83% free throw shooter this year. This is his first trip to the line today. He now has 8 to lead the Firebirds in scoring. And he's able to hit them both. Sid Berry, originally a walk-on for this UDC program, but played his way into getting a scholarship and been one of the more reliable players for head coach Mike Riley this year. Chaplin, bounce pass down low, then wasn't expecting the ball to be passed right back to him. Queen's able to recover nonetheless. Roberts pump fakes the three, and now the three from Hall misses. And we have a loose ball foul called on Queens. So the Firebirds will get some free throws coming up. Will be Anthony Matthews to the free throw line for UDC. Firebirds, 9 of 12 from the stripe this afternoon. Matthews hits the first. Gets the second one as well. This was his first trip to the line. Firebirds spreading out the number of people that have been to the free throw line in this game. Only 3 players who have played for UDC this afternoon have not been to the line in this half. Roberts, the nice finish from the left side off the glass. It's Queens back in front by 1, 34-33, 2:04 left in the half. Pace has been a bit slow in this first half with all those fouls called. Hopefully we get some more free flowing play in the second half. Jackson, the fallback, converts. And it's Firebirds ahead by 1. More pump fakes. Dishes to White. White works it to Chaplin. He has the ball knocked away by Jackson. Recovers, though he's surrounded by 3 gold jerseys. Able to get a pass off. Now, Roberts wide open in the corner, can't make the Firebirds pay. And it will be UDC basketball, 1:19 remaining in the half. It will be Matthews to inbound. He gets it into Chandler. Chandler has Folk set a screen. Now Matthews. Hands off to Jackson. Chandler into the lane. Got caught up in the air and has nothing to do with the ball. Nowhere to put it. Meanwhile, beautiful strip on Chaplin on the other end defensively for UDC. Chaplin went up with a shot and had the ball poked away out of bounds. So it will stay Queens basketball with under a minute remaining in the half. Is Moore to inbound. But before the pass, a foul on the Knights. Cameron Outlaw checks out of the game for UDC. Kasim Chandler back in for him. He'll inbounds to Matthews. Matthews works it into the front court. Now Sid Berry able to corral the pass. Hands off to Chandler. Matthews. Foot on the line. Comes up short. And now we've got a 3-second difference between shot clock and game clock. As Cameron Outlaw comes back into the game for defensive purposes for UDC. Firebirds not wanting Kasim Chandler to pick up that third foul before the half ends. Diego Maldonado also back into the game for Queens, replacing Kaiheim Chaplin. Roberts hands off to Moore. He's double teamed. Roberts open baseline, but he can't save it inbounds. Successful defense there by UDC. This Firebirds team as a whole ranks first in the ECC. In steals per game. Pardon me, second in the ECC in steals per game. Sim Chandler going to be satisfied to let some clock run off. So Firebirds look to hold for the final possession. Clock down to 7 as Chandler starts to make his move. Drives right in the lane. No whistle for a foul. Somehow they say that was a clean block. Half court heave too strong. And that's how the half will end. So the Firebirds are up by 1 after 20 minutes of play. It's been a close competitive 20 minutes of play. Expect nothing less in half number 2, so please do stick around. You're watching UDC Firebirds men's basketball here on University of the District of Columbia television.
One of the issues that I have particular interest in is mentoring women of color. A lot of the research in higher education has looked at issues with men, particularly African American men, and their persistence to graduation from college. But the data support that young women, particularly minority women, are at greater risk for dropping out of school, and if they leave school, the likelihood that they will return is much lower than the likelihood of a minority male's return to school. So we really have to do some concrete and sustainable kinds of efforts around shoring up our most vulnerable college students. And while we've spent a lot of time looking at men and minority men, the data support that minority women are probably at greater risk, not of getting to college. They'll get to college probably in higher number, but they're at greater risk of completing.
From court to court and lane to lane, under the lights or under the sun, no one delivers Division II sports like NCAA.com. The center of D2 is inside the NCAA.com hub, with exclusive highlights of every sport and live broadcasts of every Division II championship, found nowhere else. Make NCAA.com yours, the home of Division II college sports.
What if you could invest in the future of kids, like a stock? Not the kind of stock that's about making money, but a stock for social change. A whole new kind of investment called Better Futures. When you invest, it helps kids go to college. Believe in us, invest in us, watch us grow.
My name is Sydney, and I'm your dividend.
Eli Perlstein back with you as we get underway here in the second half from the UDC Sports Complex. Firebirds up by 1 over the Queens College Knights. Will be Firebirds basketball from the front court baseline. Firebirds in that first half led in scoring by Reggie Sidbury, who had 9 points on 3 of 7 shooting from the field. Queens was led by Marquise Roberts, who had 10 points on 3 of 6 shooting from the field. He also led the team with 5 rebounds. For the Firebirds, Anthony Matthews and Khalil Jackson led the way, each with 4 rebounds. Some other numbers from that first half of play. Firebirds shot 37.9 from the field. 37.9%, that is, from the field. 22.2% from 3 and 78.6% from the free throw line. Queen shot 42.3% from the field, 30% from 3, and 90% from the free throw line. So shooting numbers slightly in favor of Queens, as that's a big three-pointer hit by Kevin Buron to put Queens up by 2, 37-35. However, the Firebirds did get to the free throw line 4 more times, and they made 2 more free throws total than Queens. They also controlled the turnover battle 10-6 in that first half, as the Firebirds outscored Queens in terms of points off turnovers 13-2. Rebounds, however, went the way of Queens 20-17. Here's White in the front court for Queens. Now a minute into the second half. He drives and puts up the shot off the backboard and in for 2. So it's 39-38, Queens on top. Chandler hands off to Nickerson. Williams sets a screen. Nickerson in there playing with 3 fouls. Butler with 2 fouls fires the 3. It's too strong and got a loose ball foul. Will go against the Knights. Goes against Tyree White. So team's second foul of the half. And White's second personal. No one with more than 2 personals for Queens. Meanwhile, for UDC, Joseph Nickerson the only one with 3. Firebirds retake the lead now 40-39 with 18:15 to go in the ballgame. White walks it into the front court, working against Nickerson. Drives into the paint, kicks out wide. Here's Roberts making his way in the lane and gets past Williams for the score. 41-40, Queens by 1. 17:52 to go in the ballgame. Chandler hands off to Nickerson. Deep 2 from straight away, rims out. Rebound hauled down by Buron. White drives left to the lane, had a step on Nickerson as he put on the afterburners. And the lead is up to 3. Largest lead in the first half was 7 for Queens. Firebirds never led by more than 2. Zitberry, the deep 2, off the mark. Rebound hauled down by Moore. Into the front court, bounce pass to the baseline for White, and he's hammered as he goes up with a shot. That's what we call a very good foul. Stops the clock with 17:09 to go. In terms of who led for the majority of that first half, Queens led for 15 minutes, 43 seconds. UDC led for just 3:05 of the half. The game was tied for 47 seconds. So White looks like starting to heat up a bit here in the second half. Tyree White, the leading scorer for Queens on the season, averaging 17.1 points per game. Connects on the first. Khalil Jackson checks in for Kyle Williams for UDC. The foul was committed by Reggie Sidbury, his second personal. Sent right to the line. Strength of White's game is his rebounding. At least it has been this season. Nickerson inbounds to Chandler, who will be left alone to walk it into the front court. Working against Roberts. Bounce pass left to Nickerson. He'll take it in the lane, and a jump ball as Nickerson brought the ball down towards his waist and then tried to go up with the shot. When it was at his waist, defender is able to get their hands on it, force the jump. That goes down as a turnover for the Firebirds, their 8th two fewer than Queens has committed. White motions for someone to come set a screen. Lines up, dishing it off. Buron down low, working against Nickerson, shoots over him, can't convert. A foul called on Queens. Goes against Diego Maldonado, his second personal, team's third. Chandler will walk it into the front court. Bounces a pass off to Jackson. And his pass intended for Sid Perry, a little behind him. Firebirds a little out of sorts over their last couple of possessions. Queens has outscored the Firebirds 11-5 thus far here in the second half. 16-18 to go. And a crucial game for both these teams. Just a half game separating them in the standings. It's 2-on-3. But Firebirds force the issue anyways, and it's Kasim Chandler who puts it in from the right side. So a three-point game, 45-42, 16 minutes to go here in half number two. Next dead ball will be our first media timeout. Buron dishes off to Roberts. Deep two, too strong. Two Firebirds went up for the rebound. Luckily, they deflected it into the hands of Chandler. Now Chandler settles for three, comes up short. He seemed a little unsure about whether he actually wanted to put that one up. And he put it up as the defender was coming down, likely altered the shot. Now Jackson sets the screen. Butler drives and puts it off the window for two. Firebirds back within one, 45-44, 15-12 left in the half. White walks it into the front court. Swings the pass to Moore. And we have a foul away from the basketball, which brings us to the under 16 media timeout. Firebirds back within one. You're watching UDC Firebirds men's basketball on University of the District of Columbia television.
Building an advanced public system of higher learning that serves the community of the District of Columbia. We selected all of those words very carefully because they all have important meanings. Because none of it really works unless you have a public higher education system that can connect it all together. Well, one of the best kept secrets about the University of the District of Columbia is that we have many quality programs. Our workforce development unit is of a high quality and puts people in jobs each and every day. Our land grant unit, which is serving constituents all over the district. We're the only urban land grant institution in the country. I think that we have all the pieces that we can put together in a way that will allow us to take best practices, best tools, and really wipe the slate clean and redesign ourselves as an advanced public system of higher learning that can serve the district in a way that allows us to be a model of higher education in a city that wants to be a model city for the rest of the country.
Eli Pearlstein back with you here at the UDC Sports Complex. 15:02 remaining in this ball game. It's been a close competitive ball game. Appreciate you tuning in on this Saturday afternoon here on University of the District of Columbia Television. Off the inbounds pass, three put up by Moore, won't go. Rebound secured by Buron. Firebirds have struggled all season when it comes to rebounding and rebounding margin. They're last in the conference, averaging 8.8 fewer rebounds per game than their opponents. That time it doesn't cause them any harm. The Knights can't convert on either opportunity. Here's Nickerson who drills the three. Buron right in his face. And the Firebirds go up by two, matching their largest lead of the game. 14-25 remaining in the contest. White dishes off to Maldonado. He'll drive baseline and puts up a very difficult layup attempt, gets it to go off the glass. Not horrible defense by Butler. It certainly affected the shot. Maldonado, however, still able to get it to go. Chandler hands off to Jackson. Tries to work into the lane and draws a blocking foul. That stops the clock with 13:51 remaining. Fourth team foul on Queens. Third personal on Buron. Chandler gets it in to Sidbury. Now Nickerson for three. This time it won't fall. 2:08 to check in at the scorer's table for Queens. Chaplin and Hall. Maldonado drives, can't get it. Follow-up is good, however. Nice job by Maldonado sticking with it. He has been impressive this afternoon. At 9 in the first half, now has 13 to lead all scorers. Butler, the deep two, too strong. It remains a two-point game with Queens out in front. Pass somehow gets through two defenders and White with the easy finish. Don't know how Simon Green was able to thread that needle. Chandler, bounce pass left to Sidbury. Nickerson drives baseline, gets bumped in midair, cannot hit the reverse. No whistle, however. There was certainly body contact that did not get called. Now Green. Down low to White. Reverse won't go. Ball is loose. Covered by Buron. Loose again. And White chucks it off of Butler, who was on the floor for UDC, to keep possession. That's a smart heads-up play. It looks like a sort of aggressive swipe with the ball at Butler. But it's what you're taught to do. If you're fading out of bounds, how do you keep it? Possession, you throw it off a player from the opposing team. He did it aggressively, but still a smart play nonetheless. So it will be Hall to inbound for Queens. Gets it into Chaplin. Now Maldonado works against Butler. Pulls up from the elbow. And it's an air ball. We got some air ball chance from the Firebird faithful. 12:17 remaining. Nickerson rolls it into Chandler. Chandler, bounce pass right to Jackson. Back to Chandler. Fires from three and delivers. And the Firebirds back within one, 51-50. Continues to be a battle, likely will be throughout. Three-pointer from Green, he cannot answer. Buron with the body bump trying to get the loose ball, and he's able to successfully toss it off of Butler. That's twice that's happened now, and it goes out of bounds. We've reached the under 12 media timeout. What a game we have going on this afternoon. 1-point affair here on our nation's capital. You're watching University of the District of Columbia men's basketball here on University of the District of Columbia television.
As an integral part of the University of the District of Columbia, the Department of Intercollegiate Athletics provides experiences that enhance the comprehensive development of our student athletes. With a commitment to excellence, we embrace the overall mission of the NCAA with an emphasis on Division II to provide growth opportunities through academic achievement, learning in high-level athletic competition, and development of positive societal attitudes in service to community. In addition, we are committed to providing a game environment which respects fairness, courtesy, and ethical conduct towards others. We are the University of the District of Columbia, an advanced public system of higher learning where dreams begin.
.44 remaining here in the second half. Firebirds trailing by one. It is Tyrone Hall to inbound for Queens. Lobs it into Maldonado. Now Buron wide open for three, and he delivers. Miscommunication defensively for the Firebirds off that inbounds pass. It cost them. It's now a four-point game. 11:31 remaining. Chandler to the top of the arc, bounce pass left to Sidbury. He swings it into the hands of Jackson. Now down low, Nickerson tries the reverse, cannot get it to fall. It's two reverses he's had a good look at, but hasn't been able to convert. Green slowing the tempo down, gives it off to Maldonado. Now Buron down low to Green. Two smallest players on the court. Chandler and Green working on the low block. Chandler again works against Green. Swings it to Nickerson. Jackson comes to set a screen. He gets pushed. No whistle. As Chandler drives and reach in foul is called. 15 foul on Queen. Stops the clock with 10:38 left. So free throws coming up for Kasim Chandler, the Newark, New Jersey native, played his high school ball at Eastside High School. Leads the Firebirds right now with 14 points on the afternoon. He's 4 of 5 from the free throw line. Good on the first attempt. So Chandler, 4 of 8 from the field, 2 of 4 from 3 this afternoon. Has 4 rebounds, 1 assist. And he now leads all scorers with 15. Cannot get the second, however. He has lived at the free throw line this season. Again, 17th in the nation in free throw attempts, 16th in free throws made. Anthony Matthews checks in for UDC. Chandler will take a seat. Nickerson inbounds to Matthews. Nearly halfway through this second half. We've got a good one for you, folks. And prior to the pass, offensive foul called on Matthews. Team's third of the half, and the first personal on Matthews this afternoon. Green walks it into the front court. Works against Matthews. Has the ball poked away. He recovers. Now is an open lane to the hole. And a terrific finish off the glass. Make it 56-51, 5-point Knights lead. Nickerson picks up his dribble. Jackson hands off to Sidbury. Matthews back to Jackson. He'll drive left to the lane. Score the bucket and the foul. The clock stops with 9:42 remaining. Just what the Firebirds needed. Now a free throw, a made free throw would be nice as well. Chandler, the quick breather, he's back in. Trayvon Butler will take a seat. Jackson, 0 for 1 from the free throw line today. But he's able to complete the three-point play. So a two-point game, 9:42 left. Chaplin dishes to his right. Moore works against Sidbury. Finds Maldonado down low, and he's whistled for the travel. Took a step before he put it on the floor. The Firebirds, the beneficiary of that turnover. And thus far, the Firebirds have certainly been able to capitalize in terms of points off turnovers. They have 15 points off the now 13 Queens turnovers thus far. Chandler into the lane, goes up right-handed and draws the foul. That's what they need to do, attack, attack, attack. That's what Chandler's best at. Chandler previously played at Division I Quinnipiac, transferred to UDC prior to last season. What an addition he's been for head coach Mike Riley. Chandler sinks the first. So one more free throw. If made, the Firebirds will have pulled even. They do just that. Tied at 56, 9:13 left. Chaplin working the ball up court. Dishes off to Green. Folks guarding him tightly. White backing down Nickerson. Puts up a shot blocked by Jackson. That's Jackson's third block in the game. Fourth block for Jackson. Now foul committed. Firebird's fourth team foul. Second personal. Called on Folks. Sends Tyree White to the line. Came into this game a 74% free throw shooter. Queens as a team has only missed one free throw today. They're 11 of 12. There's the second miss. Rebound loose, however. White recovers and puts in the layup. A bucket that should have never happened. Firebirds had positioning. Nickerson just could not secure it, and credit White with that extra hustle. Getting the rebound of his own miss and putting it in. Now Chandler feeds Nickerson. Back to Chandler. He drives in the lane, kicks out to Nickerson for three. It's short. Rebound in the hands of Green. Now a chance to stretch their lead from four. Maldonado the three, and he drills it. The lead is seven, matches the largest of the afternoon. Firebirds want timeout, full timeout called by UDC with 8:06 remaining. Leaves the Firebirds with two timeouts left. Folks, the University of the District of Columbia is the only public university in the nation's capital and the only urban land-grant university in the United States. UDC is comprised of UDC Community College, the School of Engineering and Applied Sciences, School of Business and Public Administration, College of Arts and Sciences, College of Agriculture, Urban Sustainability and Environmental Sciences, and the David A. Clark School of Law. Folks, a reminder, please do follow UDC Athletics on Facebook, on Twitter at UDC Firebird Fans, and on YouTube at UDC Athletics One. UDC would also like to thank our corporate partner, The Days Inn Connecticut Avenue. The Days Inn is a proud sponsor and next door neighbor of UDC Athletics, located at 4400 Connecticut Ave Northwest. Looks like it will be Nickerson, Matthew, Sidbury, Chandler, and Jackson on the court for UDC. Nickerson to inbound from the baseline. For Queens, we've got Chaplin, White, Green, Moore, and Maldonado. Sidbury. About to pull up for the shot, and there's a foul away from the ball. And that brings us to the under eight. Media timeout. Firebirds trailing by seven, matches their largest deficit of the game. They've got some work to do to come back in this one. You're watching UDC Firebirds men's basketball on University of the District of Columbia television.
Being an educator is the best job in the world. My philosophy about education is maybe a little bit different. I firmly believe that education is not simply about getting our questions answered. That's probably what we typically think about when we speak about education. There is knowledge, and there is me, and I don't have that knowledge, and so how do I get that knowledge? Well, that certainly is a point. But I think there's an important step before we even can have our questions answered. We must have our answers questioned. That is about questioning what I already think I know. That has to be challenged first. That's probably the most important, the most difficult, but also the most rewarding part of being an educator.
To hit the first. Chandler continues now to lead all scorers with 18 points. Make that 19. The lead is 5. 7:57 left. Chaplin guts it in to Roberts. The Firebirds will let him walk it into the front court. Chaplin to his right to Maldonado. Now White swings left to Roberts. Right inside of the arc. Deep two. He delivers. It's 65-58. 7:31 left. Hands of defense emanating from the Queens bench. Matthews dishes off to Nickerson. Now Matthews on the give and go, feeds back to Jackson, who puts it in from right in front of the hoop. Whistle after the bucket. Not sure what that was about. Hall checks into the game for Queens. He replaces Maldonado. Huge foul disparity here in the second half. The Knights have committed 9, Firebirds just 4. It will be Chaplin to inbound for Queens. Gets it into Roberts. He's left alone to walk it up. It's game one of a slate of 4 games today involving teams in the ECC. As White is fouled as he went up with the ball. So Firebird's 15th foul will send Tyree White to the line, or pardon me, they say it was on the floor, so it will be Queens basketball from the front court baseline. Inbounds pass gets to White. Goes up over Nickerson and gets the layup off the glass. Nice job by Nickerson not committing the foul, standing his ground. Did all really he could do on a play like that. Now Nickerson trying to respond, and he does so, banking it home and drawing the foul. So a chance to cut the deficit to four. Nickerson, 2 of 2 from the line this afternoon. He's got 9 points, so he makes one of these, he'll be in double digits, along with Khalil Jackson and Kasim Chandler. Pardon me, only had one he needed to make to complete the three-point play. Now Nickerson checks out of the game. So it's a four-point game, 6:38 remaining. White in the paint, goes up over the outstretched hand of Jackson. Impressive shot. That was a high degree of difficulty despite how close to the rim he was. Chandler gets it to Matthews. Back to Chandler. Drives, then turns and fires back to Butler. Butler into the lane, hands off to Jackson. And on the pass, an offensive foul on Trayvon Butler. That's his third personal, team sixth. Comes with 6:09 remaining. And chance now for Queens to take its largest lead of the game if they get two on this possession. White, no look underneath, but the shot is blocked by Jackson. Fifth block of the game for Khalil Jackson. He has been terrific in that department. Chandler to Sid Berry for three. No. Rims out and into the hands of Chaplin. This place would have exploded had that gone through after that terrific block by Jackson. 5:37 remaining. Hall works against Jackson, goes around him, cannot finish. White the offensive rebound and put back, and White has really stepped up his game here in the second half. Now 7 boards, 23 points, and he leads all scorers. Firebirds really missing Jayon Troutman, who could have matched up pretty well against him. White drives, can't convert. But the rebound knocked out of bounds by Matthews. It will stay Queens basketball. Inbounds pass. Firebirds elapsed defensively. An easy finish by Chaplin. Now Queens starting to pull away a bit. It's a 10-point game, by far the largest lead of the game for the Knights, with 4:46 remaining. Chandler. Hands off to Matthews. Feeds Jackson for two. He connects right outside the lane. And we got a timeout called. I believe this one is called by UDC. 30-second timeout leaves the Firebirds with one timeout remaining. The University of the District of Columbia extends beyond its campus footprint, offering easy access to world-famous monuments, political intrigue, and cultural attractions everywhere you look. And education at UDC opens doors to opportunities that can only be found in the nation's capital. For more information, visit the UDC website at www.udc.edu. It will be Butler, Matthews, Chandler, Sidbury, and Jackson on the floor for UDC. Maldonado, Moore, Chaplin, Roberts, and White for Queens. Pressure in the backcourt by the Firebirds. But the Knights able to inbound nonetheless. Roberts still handling the rock. Now a foul committed away from the basketball. It goes against Reggie Sidbury. Seventh team foul on UDC, so free throws the rest of the way for the Knights. Maldonado checks out of the game. Chaplin at the free throw line. Able to convert the first. Chaplin now with 3 points. Make that four. The senior from Freeport, New York. Actually below his average of 10.8 points per game. Chandler trying to answer. He can't. And that's an offensive goaltending called on Jackson as the ball was still touching the rim when he touched it. So lead is 10, 4:10 to go. Game's been close throughout, but Queen's able to pull away a bit here in the last few minutes. Hall drives and is fouled from behind. That stops the clock with under four, so we've reached the under four media timeout. Final one of the game. Firebirds got some work to do. You're watching UDC Firebirds men's basketball here on University of the District of Columbia television.
Being a champion takes more than skill, more than endless drills, more than using your head. Being a champion takes the heart to give it your all, the agility to thrive from any angle, and the relentless drive to be the best. Welcome to Division II, where the pursuit is yours to create, and the question isn't, can you do it? It's, will you?
What if you could invest in the future? The future of kids, like a stock. Not the kind of stock that's about making money, but a stock for social change. A whole new kind of investment called Better Futures. When you invest, it helps kids go to college. Believe in us, invest in us, watch us grow.
My name is Sydney, and I'm your dividend.
Eli Perlstein back with you. 3:56 remaining. This game was a 1-2 point game either way for the majority of this contest. But Queen's pulling away a bit over the last few minutes. To make it a double digit game. Missed the first free throw. This game was tied at 56. Since then, Firebirds with 9 points. Queens with 20. So 20-9 run for the Knights. Chandler left open underneath. UDC back within nine. Now pressure in the backcourt. And Queen steps on the baseline. So they turn it over. See if the Firebirds can make a little bit of a run of their own now. That is turnover number 14 for Queens this afternoon. Pass deflected out of bounds will stay UDC basketball. Greens with the better shooting numbers from the field and from three, as well as from the free throw line today. They have committed four more turnovers. Chandler for three, short. Hall soars up to get the rebound. Time starting to become a factor for UDC. 9-point game, 3:15 left. UDC with just one timeout left. All three remaining for Queens. Hall goes up left-handed. Doesn't come near the rim. Here come the Firebirds in transition. Sid Perry to Matthews. To the elbow. Comes up short. Now Firebirds come away with the steal. Chandler into the lane, goes up right-handed, draws the foul. Surprise, Joseph Nickerson, who's not having one of his better games, but he's been sitting on the bench for a while. Surprise that he is still on the bench. He has a warm-up shirt on, so he might not be coming back into this game. Might be a little banged up as Chandler hits the first free throw. Jakeem Folks enters. Reggie Sidbury will take a seat. So it's Folks, Jackson, Butler, Matthews, and Chandler on the court for UDC. Chandler hits them both. It's a 7-point game. With 2:40 remaining. Chaplin into the corner for three, and it's drained by Moore. Firebirds willing to risk that. Does not pay off. Now Chandler trying to answer, and his shot attempt, a layup attempt blocked out of bounds, stays UDC basketball. Sidbury checks back in. Matthews has a seat. Or pardon me, Folks has a seat. Inbounds pass. Jackson slips. And Firebirds need to call timeout to bail him out. So Firebirds burn their final timeout of the game. But still 2:15 left. It's definitely an uphill climb for the Firebirds right now, trailing by 10. I mentioned this is one of combined four games going on today involving ECC teams. Let's take a look at the other games on the men's side going on this afternoon. We have one final from earlier. Damon, a winner at Mercy today, 82-72. Roberts, Wesleyan, and Malloy played earlier today at 2. That game should be final, but no score update from that one. 7:55 to go in the second half at NYIT. St. Thomas Aquinas leads at NYIT 70-51. Of course, our game here, a 10-point contest with 2:16 to go. Sidbury, Jackson, Matthews, Chandler, and Butler. Again, no sign of Joseph Nickerson. He hasn't played in quite a few minutes. He only has three fouls, so it's not because he is fouled out. Butler has four fouls. Next foul for him, he's gone. Bucket is good, and it's 79-71. So 8-point game. Under two to go. Still time, but not much for the Firebirds to come back. 19th foul on UDC. Committed by Jackson, his third personal. So it's Tyheim Chaplin at the free throw line. Chaplin, one of eight Knights players who returned from a year ago. This Queens team went 11-14 last year. If they can hang on today, they would match their win total from last season. Except instead of being three games under 500 as they were at the end of last season, they would be three games over 500. Jackson gets the layup and draws the foul. What the Firebirds needed for the clock to stop and a chance at a three-point play. You know, like for UDC, they just want to try and extend this game now as long as possible. So they're likely not going to see much flow to this one here in these last couple minutes of game time. Jackson has it rim out. Moore secures the rebound for the Knights. Costly miss from the stripe there for UDC. Grant wide open, or pardon me, that's Chaplin wide open, and he delivers a big blow. 11-point game, a minute 32 left. Chandler drives, comes up short. Jackson the offensive rebound. He puts it in from the right side. And it's 84-75. Minute 22 left. The Firebirds cannot hang on. They'd fall to 7-3 at home this season. Chandler pokes the ball free, but can't keep it in bounds. Firebirds would fall to 7-4 in conference play and 10-9 overall. Queens with the win will improve to 11-8 overall, 8-4 in conference play. 6-6 away from home. 500 on the road is really not a bad road record at all. Clock stops with 109 remaining. It's Marquise Roberts at the free throw line. Next up for the Firebirds, two more on the road. They are at Roberts Wesleyan next Wednesday night, 7 p.m. tip. Then at a very hostile environment at St. Thomas Aquinas next Saturday the 4th. That is going to be a tough, tough game, and St. Thomas Aquinas will be looking for revenge for the Firebirds' victory here in D.C. back in December. Butler drives, has a clean look at the basket and scores. It's 86-77, 9-point game, 58.3 left. Roberts dishes off to Chaplin, who will let some time run off. Surprised the Firebirds haven't fouled right away. Now they commit the foul that's committed by Matthews, stopping the clock with 47.4 left. Firebirds' next home game is February 11th. We'll have that for you here on University of the District of Columbia Television. Men against NYIT will tip at 3 p.m. Women against NYIT tip prior to that at 1. UDC Women lost earlier this afternoon. Their losing streak extends to 13 games. The Firebirds, they can't come back in this final 47 seconds. Their losing skid will hit 3 after winning 4 in a row. Queens looking for their first win here in D.C. in 3 years. Butler drives, score the bucket and the foul. So a chance to pull within 8. This is Butler's first trip to the free throw line today. He has 6 points. Firebirds are led in scoring by Kasim Chandler's 23. Khalil Jackson with 20. Nickerson with 10. For Queens, Tyree White has 23. Roberts with 16. Same with Maldonado and Chaplin with 11. So it's an 8-point game. 37.9 left. Chaplin ahead to Roberts, and on the pass, foul committed. It's a blocking foul on Kasim Chandler. So Chaplin back at the free throw line to add to his totals. Next up for Queens, they will return home, take on Malloy on Wednesday night in the Coaches vs. Cancer game. 7:30 p.m. tip to that one. They will then be back out on the road at Roberts Wesleyan a week from Wednesday on February 8th. Taking a look at the conference standings heading into today, or with today's one final that's in the book. Firebirds with a loss fall to 7-4. They would, however, remain, or pardon me, no, they would fall behind Damon and Queens, would both be 8-4. Firebirds would fall from a tie for second to fifth place, but would still be in postseason position. Finger roll lay-in, good for Matthews. The lead is sliced to 7. White gets a pass off quickly to Chaplin, who's fouled from behind. Again, Firebirds are out of timeouts, but Queen still has 3 left. Two more free throws coming up for Chaplin. He's 7 of 8 from the line this afternoon. Hits the first. Chaplin now with 13 points. Make that 14. Under 20 left. Butler for 3. He gets it. And hold on, folks. It's now a 2-possession game. 15 remaining. Firebirds still haven't fouled. And it looks like they've conceded this one. Little surprise there. They've called off the horses. But too little, too late. So our final, Firebirds fall 91-85. So Firebirds now fall to 10-9 overall this season. While again, Queens matches their win total from a year ago. They improved to 11-8, and they're now 8-4 in conference play, while the Firebirds fall to 7-4. Firebirds still in position for a postseason berth and a berth in the conference tournament, but still obviously a little more than a month remaining in the regular season. But this is a costly loss for them. They've got to regroup now and try and find a way to end this 3-game skid they're on.